Hello students, welcome to Study IQ. We will continue with our discussion on sociology question series. Okay, so before that, if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing the channel first. Okay, so let's continue with our discussion. Here in this session, as you have seen in the thumbnail, we are going to discuss about the concept of religion according to Weber and Marx. So how their perspective vary and what is their understanding about religion. So basically, I want to tell you a single thread and from where you need to develop your answer. Okay, so if you see, religion is what we are actually going to discuss. So when we talk about religion, what is what is the relation between religion and capitalism according to Weber and according to Marx? So we will have to talk about Marx and Weber. Okay, so Marx versus Weber, religion. So first of all, you can say it is all related to macro. Marx is giving importance to societal reality, macro, and Weber is giving importance to micro, and all these are general things. Okay, but apart from this, what is the most important point that you need to pick from this particular question, or the way you need to develop your question? The thread is actually the reverse relationship that they are talking about. I have seen many people are writing the answers without writing or without mentioning the reverse relationship. You talk about the view of capitalism, view of religion, you talk about the reasons, okay, and you talk about the methods that they use, you talk about the solutions. In fact, Weber is not talking about any solutions, he's only explaining the concept. But different dimensions, just for the sake of explaining something you are talking in the answer. But it is very rarely I can see that, you know, people are coming up with the reverse relation. Actually, that is where you need to pick. So Marx and Weber is talking an entirely different relation between capitalism and, you know, religion. For example, when we discussed about division of labor of Durkheim and alienation of Marx, both are polar opposites, both are entirely different concept. For Marx, division of labor result into alienation. For Durkheim, division of labor is giving the much required autonomy to the individual to produce. That we have already done. So exactly in the similar way, what Marx says it is the religion which is product of capitalism. So I would say capitalism actually created religion, right? The capitalist setup or the capitalist ideology actually created religion for the functioning of capitalism. For example, if you see, Marx is talking about economic infrastructure, which comprise of FOP, ROP, forces of production, relation of production, etc. I'm not getting into that, we have already done that. And it creates the social superstructure like this. So social superstructure, which involves religion, family, culture, education, all these elements. Okay, why? Because this economic infrastructure shapes the superstructure, which in turn will help in the functioning of the economic infrastructure. This is what we have discussed when it comes to the basics of Marx. And religion is a part of superstructure. So what is creating religion? It is the economic infrastructure. In the capitalist society, it is a capitalist system which is creating the religion for the functioning of the system. So religion is helping in the functioning of the system. So capitalism created religion, which in turn helping in the functioning of capitalism. So capitalism created religion, and religion help in the functioning of capitalism. How? Religion is acting as an opiating agent. Religion is the hurt of hurtless world, soul of soulless condition, and the opium of masses according to Marx. So religion preach that you suffer maximum in this world and you get heaven in the next world. So that is actually motivating the workers to get exploited in this world. This is according to Marx. See, the same thing, all these superstructural institutions, if you see, family is also an exploitative device. Because of family only you are going to the workplace and getting exploited, otherwise you won't go. Then if you talk about education is merely creating the labors which is required for the capitalist society. If you talk about the parliament is the executive committee of bourgeois, constitution is the document of bourgeois. So this is how he is understanding everything, because all these are falling under the superstructure. So this is a kind of understanding that you need to develop. Once you understood economic infrastructure, superstructure, and economic infrastructure create the superstructure, and if you know what all elements will come in superstructure, all these elements like family, religion, culture, education, politics, everything will come there. All these will help in the functioning of capitalism. So that is his view on a religion. Okay, religion is created by the capitalist and the system for the functioning of the system. Whereas Weber gives exactly the opposite idea. So what Weber says is, it is the religion which is creating the capitalism. For example, he identified that in modern Europe, if you see most of the capitalists, they are from Protestants. Most of the professionals, most of the business people, most of the rich people, all are Protestants in modern Europe. So he was able to analyze a correlation between them, and he finally concluded that it is because of the religion they became capitalist. So there are certain ethics, there are certain values in the Protestant ethic that made them capitalist. So it is a religion which created capitalist. So you can see here the reverse relationship. What Weber says, religion created capitalism. For to be more specific, Protestant ethic or Protestant religion resulted into capitalism. What Marx says, see Weber and Marx, you can see here how you can write. This is W, if you invert it is Marx. So exactly the opposite. In fact, whatever Marx said, exactly the opposite is what Weber is saying. If you remember when we discussed about class polarization, what Marx said the classes will be polarized into upper class, this is haves, and have-nots. There are intermediate class, but through the process of proletarianization and through the process of bourgeoisation, the entire process is class polarization will happen. But what Weber said, that never happened and that will never happen. Instead, middle class is widening. So entirely opposite contribution you can see when it comes to Weber and Marx. So here, just like W and M, both are polar opposites, okay, and Weber is writing in the presence of Marx's ghost. That statement is there. Okay, we will discuss about all those things. In fact, we have already covered that. So here, this is a thread that you need to pick, and then you need to explain. So Marxian concept of religion I have already done, so you can go through that videos. So here what I'll do is I'll explain the concept of Weber. I just need this simple block diagram to explain entire concept of theory of religion which is given by Weber. So what Weber says is, he identified a correlation between Protestants and capitalists, right? Because most of the Protestants are capitalist. So what he did is, he want to make a theory. So he created ideal types of Protestant ethic and ideal types of capitalism. And he went for a comparative analysis. So the Protestant ethic and theory, this theory is actually an exhibition of the use of scientific methods in sociology for the purpose of ensuring objectivity. He used causal pluralism or causal probabilism, which is the most important pillar of Weber's methodology. You can see the extensive use of ideal type here. And if the question is asked about ideal type, you can give this as a very good example. We have already seen that social action before, and in that also we talked about ideal type, traditional action, affective action, Zweck rational action, Wirth rational action, all were ideal type. We have discussed about authority. There we have discussed about traditional authority, charismatic authority, rational legal authority. All these are again ideal types that is created by Weber. And in fact, Parson also created ideal types in his theory of social action. So all these discussions are done. So if the question is about ideal type, you will not face any problem. Even this also you can write as an example. So here, if you see what Weber did, he created, in fact, we discussed this theory already, but still I'm discussing it further in this context. So he created the ideal types of capitalism, and he created the ideal type of Protestant ethic. So what he said is, instead of Protestant ethic, there are different sects in the Protestant ethic. Different varieties are there, different cult sects are there. So he selected the basic of all, that is Calvinism. And some principles which is followed by Calvinism is what he has taken as a Protestant ethic, because he is talking about ideal type. Ideal types are the regularities, regularly seen elements. That is the most common meaning for the people. Okay, for example, when I talk about ideal type, so what do you mean? If you talk about family, what are the ideal types? Ideal types are the regularities. When I say economic security, one of the ideal type, emotional security, ideal type, sexual gratification, it is a regularity, ideal type. Taking care of child, taking care of aged, all these are the ideal types of family. But if I talk about only one thing, you cannot conclude that I'm talking about family. If simply I'm talking about emotional security, it is not necessarily family. If simply I'm talking about taking care of child, there are a lot of child care centers to take care of child. Similarly, if I'm simply talking about taking care of aged, that is also an ideal type of family, but you cannot understand because there are old age homes, etc. If I'm talking about sexual gratification, it is not necessary, family is required for that. But if you combine everything, all these things, then only one institution which satisfy all these things. So what is the role of ideal type? The role of ideal type is basically to explain the reality. Within themselves, single elements are meaningless. You cannot explain the reality, but when combined, you can explain the reality. So similarly, he is constructing ideal type of capitalism here. So he is also constructing the ideal type of Protestant ethic, and then he make a comparative analysis, and that comparative analysis you can see from this diagram. But before that, let's see the ideal types that he constructed for Protestant ethic and spirit of capitalism or capitalism. So if you take Protestant ethic, the first ideal type is like, what are the ethics which are to be followed, or for that matter, it is all about, it's God created the world for its own glory, and no mediation of priest can actually help to know the God. So these priests and all these are corrupt people. There is no point in, you know, going and paying for these priests. You don't want to donate to priest. So all these are the ideas of Protestants. But in Catholicism, it is entirely different, right? So you will go to the priest, you will talk to the priest, and you know, you are thinking that when you talk to the priest, the problems can be solved, and you will donate to the priest, and then God will be helping you. So the your Catholic religion is thinking that, you know, the priest can help to know the God, priest can help you to take you through the God. So all these are, and priest can sometimes replace the God in giving forgiveness and all those things. Okay, so here when we talk about Protestant ethic, first one, God created the world for its own glory, and he is unknowable. No mediation of priest can help. So there is no point in donating to the priest, no point in depending on the priest or anything. So I'm just writing here own glory. Okay, so God created the world for its own glory. Secondly, what I want to tell us, second one is doctrine of predestination. So I will just write here predestination. That means your destiny is actually fixed. Whether you're going to enter into heaven or hell, it is actually fixed by the God, and no mediation of priest can know that, and no mediation of priest can change that. So then there is again no role for priest. Okay, so here they actually practice strict individualism. Now if you remember in the theory of suicide by Durkheim, I have told you Protestants commit more suicide than Catholics. The reason you can interpret from here itself, at that time also I have told you the reason, actually because Protestants are more individualistic, they have less integration with the community, less integration with the society. And you know, in case of Catholics, even if you have any problem, you committed some mistakes and all, you can go to the priest and you can talk to the priest, and he will offer the forgiveness and everything, so you can start a new life and all those things is there. You are much more integrated with the society. But when it comes to Protestant ethic, you are much more individualistic. The integration is very less. So because of, and if you remember the reasons that we have talked about why people committing suicide, the suicidogenic forces, forces of integration and forces of regulation, right? So I've told you low integration is one of the reason, and that lead to anomy suicide. So most of the Protestants commit suicide, and that suicide come under anomy, because less integrated with the society, less integrated with the church, less integrated with the priest. So all these things, okay? That is different context, but I have just told you, since we have taken up this word Protestants, at the same time we have before also mentioned this in Durkheim. So here, doctrine of predestination, that means heaven or not, it is already fixed by the God. Third is this worldly asceticism, and that makes them follow the strict self-discipline. Okay, and money should not be wasted, hard work for the glory of God. So these are again, okay, I have this printed. So you can see here, doctrine of predestination. Some people are chosen by God to enter into heaven, and nobody can know one is chosen or not. No priest can help in this matter. Again, this worldly asceticism. A Protestant ethic suggests strict self-discipline, simple lifestyle with no enjoyment, and hard work. This is hard work for the glory of God. Notion of calling means all work is sacred, and it is not mere work. It is actually a calling from the God. It is actually a mission. So for example, I'm teaching. It is actually a mission. It is not just mere work. I'm not sitting here just because I want to survive. I take it as a calling. I take it as a mission, and which is given by God to take you through the civil service examination. So that is what you mean by notion of calling. So that has to be, for example, you want to become an IAS officer. That is actually a calling from the God. That, and there is a mission which is given to you by the God. So you have to consider it as a mission, and you have to accomplish it. Okay. So for example, teachers, doctors, all these are calling of the God or the mission. And that you have to do it with devotion. So I'm teaching here, and I'm giving my 100%, and I'm not here only for money. So it is done, you know, with a devotion. It is a sacred task. Okay, it is not a mere work. Work should be treated as a sacred task, and it has to be done with devotion. It is not mere work. Okay, so all these are the elements of Protestant ethics. So you just need to remember these four. First one, world created for its own glory, doctrine of predestination, this worldly asceticism, notion of calling. Okay, now ideal types of capitalism, it is all about profit motive, and wealth should not be used for enjoyment. Wealth should be used for more money, so that is related to wealth. Individualism, capitalism promotes strict individualism, hard work, innovation, profit motive, etc. And some ethics in capitalism are work should be done well, time is money, worker is the means to an end, workers worship, all these are the ethics. So how can you remember this? You can remember this WIPE. Okay, so WIPE. So this is wealth should be used for creation of more wealth, individualism, profit, and various ethics. These are the various ethics. Now after this, what he do is he make a comparative analysis, and that you can see from this diagram. I'll explain with this diagram. So first, what I have told you is the doctrine of predestination. So that means heaven or not, it is already fixed. So that will lead to heaven or not, that lead to insecurity and tension among the minds of the followers. They don't know whether they are chosen by the God or not, right? So feeling of anxiety and loneliness among the followers, that lead to feeling of anxiety and loneliness among the followers. And because of that, what they do, they will do intense worldly activity as success was an indicator of being chosen or not. So they will try to do a lot of hard work, because if you are successful in this world, that is an indicator of being chosen by God. So if you are successful here, you are chosen by the God to enter into heaven. So you try your maximum to be successful in this world, and you go for a lot of hard work. Okay, and this act as the spirit to capitalism, the hard work that you're doing. So that is what spirit. Also, this worldly asceticism promotes savings and investment, and notion of calling will promote the devotion. So all these will act as the spirit to capitalism. But spirit alone is not enough. Some other things is also required. During this time in Europe, you can see new factory system, accounting techniques, tools and machinery, new political system all emerged. So coupled with that, when spirit was also there, this acted as the substance, and that led to the development of capitalism. Alone, spirit is there, I am ready to work hard, but that doesn't mean that I can become a capitalist. All these were available at that time. And you see, one of the most important pillar of Weber's methodology, causal pluralism. He is establishing plurality of cause here. Not only spirit, substance. That's what we mean by plurality. Of course, for example, you are preparing for civil services. So what is the spirit here? That you're going to become very powerful, you're going to become very famous, you're going to get a lot of prestigious, and the life will be good. All these are the spirit in preparation of this exam. What is the substance? Substance is the kind of good teachers like me, and then the materials, the test series, and everything, right? So these are the substance. So if you have spirit, okay, that alone will not work. You also need to have all these materials, good teacher, good mentor, and good test series, good content. Everything has to be there. Both together will work, and you can qualify for the exam. Spirit alone will not do. Similarly, substance alone, all these materials are there, all these teachers are there, teachers like me are available, and you can see a lot of content, a lot of teachers, all the facilities are given to you, but you have no interest, you are not reading, you are not preparing, you cannot become civil servant, IAS officer, right? So simply, similar way, you can interpret this also. So I hope you understood. Now see, before that, all these things we have already done. I don't know Weber theory is uploaded or not, but Marx theories are in fact uploaded. I think up till Durkheim only it is uploaded. So if you missed out all those videos, you can get in touch with me here. This is my Instagram ID, Zia Safir, or this is my Telegram channel. You can join the Telegram channel, you will get all my videos there. Not only sociology, I have done history, almost 80% of history is done over there. Economy, all these are, you know, I have almost completed economy, around 300 videos you can see in the Telegram channel. Quantitative aptitude, it's done. Ethics videos are also done, and we are starting a new series from the next month for ethics. New series for history already started after completing the first series. Okay, so or if you want to write answers with me, or if you want to write a test series or answer writing program or mentorship program or guidance, anything, you can get in touch with me for the formal test series or the answer writing program. So this is my contact number, 9790 892 697, or 9895 77 775. okay, or regular classes or live classes, I have all these. Okay, so if you wish to attend those classes, or if you wish to attend the test series with me, you can get only if you need to attend the test series, please contact me. So this is the case we are talking about. The understanding of religion according to Marx and Weber. Now, in fact, when Weber is talking about the spirit and substance, he also compared the religions of China, India and Jews, right? See, what he's saying in case of China is the spirit was there. The China's a very well developed economy and every raw materials is there. All the facility are there. But the Confucius ethic prevent the capitalism because that promoted traditionalism, okay, family obligations, etc. So spirit was absent in China, but substance was there. Just like you may not be interested in preparing for civil service, but everything is available. So spirit is not there, substance is there. In case of India also, spirit was absent because the Hindu religion talking about karma, dharma, punarjanma, and it is based on otherworldly asceticism. So spirit was absent, substance was present in India also. There are criticism, I am talking about Weber's view. The criticism, Milton Singer criticism, etc. you can very well use here, that you can talk about the study of industrialist of Madras, and you can say the elements of Hinduism which promote capitalism, there are a lot of studies which is contradicting Weber. That I will discuss when we discuss about criticism. In fact, you need to write criticism towards the end of this answer also. But I'm trying to develop this thread here, this part. There's a major difference. There's a core difference. So, and apart from that, when it comes to Jews, the problem is spirit was there. Their religion promote capitalism. There are elements in their religion to promote capitalism, but substance was not there because the Jews were scattered because of many historical factors. So we have criticism for all these, and we will also have to accommodate the criticism. But understand, he also made studies on Hindu religion, Indian religion, Chinese religion, and Judaism. And he explained why capitalism did not arise in those countries as well. Okay, so I hope this discussion is clear. I'm expecting that only this diagram is enough for you to understand the complete story. Okay, so Marx is talking about reverse relationship. So you need this diagram, you need to explain this diagram, you need to explain this diagram. Economic infrastructure, shapes, superstructure, which in turn, this is shapes. So here comes religion, which in turn help in the functioning of, this is what Marx says, and exactly the opposite. See, the Protestant ethic shaped or created capitalism. This is what Weber says. So this is how you need to frame this answer. Apart from that, if you want to, you can talk about micro, who care for that? Nobody care for that in this particular context. When you have this big difference, but you see, most of the people are writing about micro macro difference. Weber is giving importance to individual. Marx is giving importance to society. You get nothing if you're writing all these things. You get nothing. Literally, you get nothing. You won't get any mark. No sociology. The paper is evaluated by a sociologist. You will never get marks. Okay, they will never give marks unless and until this point is reflected in the answer. Okay, that is the reason why I'm explaining this point. So in the next session, again, I'll continue with this kind of discussions. So maybe I'll talk about organic mechanic solidarity. I'll talk about sacred profane. I talk about Parsons moving equilibrium, all these concepts, all these questions. Now I'm taking this question wise discussions are going on. And later I'll take up actual last 5 year paper one, paper two, question paper, and I'll sit with you and I'll show you how to solve it, how you allocate the time and how will you approach each answers, how will you pick the questions. Everything will be discussed towards the end. Okay, so this is the idea. So that's it from my side for this particular session. So I hope you understood the basic difference between Marx and Weber with respect to the framework of religion. One person says capitalism created religion, the other person says simply religion created capitalism, Protestant ethic created capitalism. Okay, so there was a question last year related to this only. So according to Weber, it is Protestant ethic created religion, but according to Marx, it is religion created Protestant ethic. That is a specific question, because anyway, if you understood this, you just need to know economic infrastructure creates superstructure. Religion is part of superstructure. Any religion will fit into this. So this economic infrastructure creates Protestant ethic also, Islamic ethic also, Hinduism ethic also, according to Marx. Whatever be the religion, all talking about same, all are created by the economic infrastructure. So it doesn't matter whether they are asking about, you know, specifically the reverse relationship. Okay, so still the answer remains the same. So I hope you understood. We'll stop here. please get in touch with me. I've already given you my contact number if you wish to write the test series or if you need to join the answer writing programs. Okay, so this is my Instagram ID. Follow me there and join the Telegram channel also. So see you guys. Thank you.